Let's have a look at this very simple if else end branching. Also reads almost just like English. So I'm going to create this computer variable. I'm going to call it value. Inside of it, I'm going to put an integer value, and that being 10. So I write this if statement. The first line is going to evaluate something. If the value is less than 10, print this. It is less than 10, which of course it isn't. And if it returns a false, it jumps to the next line. Else if. And another else if. You can nest many else ifs in here, but it's going to go down one by one by one until it finds something that's true. If it does not find anything that's true, so there 10 is not less than 10, it skips all the lines of code until it gets to the next else if. If that one was true, it would actually do whatever's written after the else if and jump all the way to the end. If it's false, and indeed 10 is not more than 10, it just skips that line altogether and goes to the next else if, etc., etc., etc. So you can nest many else ifs in here. And then if all else fails, you can always have this last else and have it do something, just in case all of these, that first if and all the subsequent else ifs, if they're all untrue, they all return a false, you can always have this last escape, which is just an else, and it'll print out. Once one of them are true, though, it's just going to execute that and then jump out anyway. So in this instance, they're all going to return false, so it's going to just jump to this very last one that says the value is 10, and print that out, print that as a line out to the screen. If one of them was true, though, if any one of these returned a true, it would execute that line of code in between the statements and then jump outside to this end. It won't carry on, and it won't do the else either. It's just looking for the very first true statement that it finds, executes that line of code. If it finds nothing, it's going to execute whatever is in the else statement. Once again, you can also nest things within in each other, but this continued iterative use of else ifs can be pretty clear and make things quite easy. You can do quite a bit with it.